The Bin Hazareth are concerned about the breach. Magic out of control like that could cause trouble everywhere. I've been ordered to join the Inquisition, get close to the people in charge, and send reports on what's happening. But I also get reports from Bin Hazareth agents all over Orlais. You sign me on, I'll share them with your people.
What would you send home in these reports of yours?
Enough to keep my superiors happy. Nothing that'll compromise your operations. The Qunari want to know if they need to launch an invasion to stop the whole damn world from falling apart. You let me send word of what you're doing, it'll put some minds at ease. That's good for everyone.
You're a Qunari spy, and you just told me.
Whatever happened at that conclave thing, it's bad. Someone needs to get that breach closed. So whatever I am, I'm on your side.
You still could have hidden what you are.
From something called the Inquisition? I'd have been tipped sooner or later. Better you hear it right up front from me.
What's in these Bin Hazareth reports you're offering to share?
Enemy movements, suspicious activity, intriguing gossip. It's a bit of everything. Alone they're not much, but if your spy master is worth a damn, she'll put him to good use.
She?
I did a little research. Plus, I've always had a weakness for redheads.
All right, you're in.
Excellent. Prem, tell the men to finish drinking on the road. The Chargers just got hired.
What about the casks, Chief? We just opened them up with axes.
Find some way to seal them. You're Tervinter, right? Try blood magic. We'll meet you back at Haven.
Those must be the bandits Harding mentioned.
So you spend a lot of time around dead people?
Corpses. As Navarans, we pay respect to the departed in family crypts.
Pay respect? Like, pose them and dress them up and such?
Not in the way you're picturing.
It sounds like a big dead dollhouse. Dollhouses are creepy enough.
Well, now you know.
What am I supposed to do with that?
where does this lead?
You're smirking again, like in that fight before. What's so funny?
The simplest spell had you white as a sheet. I've shrugged off worse in practice.
Well, sorry I'm scared of the stuff I've been warned about my whole life, like most people who aren't seekers.
I apologize. I could help if you're willing.
No, I have things to do. You can help by standing in front of me.
That I can do.
These must be the missing soldiers.
We should see that their families are notified.
It looks like the bandits are camped further along the beach.
Those are the forging tools of an apprentice. Wouldn't you like to use the hammer of a master? Good day. Or good as it could be with the sky ripped apart.
What kind of person stays to run a shop at a time like this?
The kind with nowhere else to go. Those blasted demons destroy most of my goods. If I stay here, work some contacts, I can start rebuilding. Maybe, just maybe, help you folks out in the process.
You must speak with most everyone here. How are people doing?
Hope and fear in equal measure. No one really knows what it means when an Inquisition is called. Yet. I imagine it's no better for you. You've got my sympathies, for what it's worth.
Until later.
Stay safe.
enchant of Vivienne as well. She remains.
Speak only the word. Sing only.
Thank you for all that you are doing to
bend
me.
The gold.
Let us begin. My scouts still comb the hills for clues about the explosion. I'll take what I can find.
work?
Let's see what we have.
Though you had granted them power over the very Fade itself, though they sang hymns of praise unending, though they...
Thank you for all that you are doing to her. Greetings, Herald of Ondraste. How fares your quest to seal the breach?
I'm doing everything within my power.
A task, such as closing the breach, is a heavy burden. I hope you do not carry it alone. We remember Ondraste, but Ondraste did not carry the Chant of Light alone. She had generals, advisors, and though it is considered heresy to say it, she had the aid of the elf Chartan. Do everything within your power, but remember those who would help you.
I appreciate your insight, Mother Giselle.
Take it for whatever it is worth. You walk a difficult path, and there is little enough I can do to aid you. In any case, I pray this Inquisition proves less brutal than its predecessor.
Do you know who the Grand Clerics will choose as the next Divine?
It is a difficult decision. All the obvious candidates perished with Divine Justinia at the Conclave. The Grand Clerics are terrified of the Inquisition. They will not decide soon, and I fear they will not decide wisely. Whoever is chosen needs the Inquisition's support. No one else seems likely to seal the breach.
Growing up Dalish, I heard little about your chantry. Can you tell me about it?
Of course. Too many think that the Chant of Light should only be sung by humans. The truth is that knowledge of the Maker and Ondraste should be open to all who wish to learn of him. We believe the Maker created us, and that mankind's sinful nature caused him to turn away. With Ondraste's blessing, the Maker will forgive mankind once the Chant of Light is sung from all corners of this world.
What is your stance on magic?
Ondraste put it simply. Magic must serve man, not rule over him. However, those words must be put into the proper historical context. Ondraste led a rebellion against the Devinter Imperium, whose magisters controlled most of the world at the time. Even then, she never called for all mages to be put to death. She believed in peaceful coexistence.
I don't recall the Chantry being as tolerant of magic as you describe.
No. The Chantry is an imperfect vessel, pulled in every direction by those who would steer its course. Yet the Templars rebelled precisely because Divine Justinia was not restrictive enough. Perhaps the Inquisition will find a better way.
Why does the Chantry allow only human women to become priestesses?
The official doctrine is that elves and dwarves have turned further from the Maker than humanity. And as for men, the chant holds that they are more vulnerable to anger or passion. But in truth, it is simply political, added after Andraste's death, like too many of our beliefs.
If you don't believe these restrictions are what Andraste wanted, why haven't you tried to change them?
Has the current state of the world not taught you the folly of fighting too many battles at once? I chose to use what power I had to help peasants forgotten by the nobles of Orlais. I believed there would be time to address their inequality under the Chantry once we had saved them from starving.
There were calls for an exalted march to put down the Mage Rebellion. What was your opinion?
It was ignorant gossip. An exalted march only succeeds when it carries the will of the people. Even then, it cannot be undertaken lightly. People are too easily frightened. We cannot destroy everything they fear. An exalted march is justified only against a true threat to this whole world. It is an offense to the Maker to use it as a political bludgeon, or as a means of spreading the chant of light.
A pity voices like yours were not louder when an exalted march crushed my people.
That is a hotly debated matter in some circles of the Chantry. Your people had conquered Mont-Semeld and threatened Val-Réau itself. They were not helpless victims. But even then, Orlais was the only nation to provide troops. It was hardly an exalted march of all the faithful. The Maker wishes his world to spread by example, not by war. We win no converts with blood.
Farewell.
Maker go with you.
With passioned breath does the darkness creep. It is the whisper in the night, the lie of the moon. I did not...
Did you need something?
Anything I should know?
I've nothing to report at the moment.
I'll leave you to your work.